Navagraha are the nine heavenly bodies and deities that influence human life on earth according to Hinduism and Hindu astrology. This video will narrate to you the various aspects and stories associated with the seventh of the Navagraha, Shani. To know more about the other planets of Navagraha, watch the playlist linked in the comments below. Shani is the Hindu god of justice and the ruler of the planet Saturn. He is the god of karma, justice, and retribution, and delivers results depending on one's thoughts, speech, and deeds. This powerful god keeps a record of karmic deeds of human and passes his judgments upon them during their lifetime, unlike his brother Yama, who makes his judgment only after the human has passed away. Lord Shani is described as lame-legged or limp, as he was injured while fighting with his brother Yama in his childhood. He is represented riding a chariot pulled by a crow or a vulture, or an iron chariot with eight horses and carrying a bow and an arrow. He is usually depicted with dark skin, wearing black clothes. The Vishnu Puran tells the story of the birth of Shani, that unable to bear Surya's intense heat, that his wife Samugna, after giving birth to her three children, retires to the forest to practice harsh austerities in the form of a mare, leaving her shadow image Chhaya behind. Chhaya Devi is the Hindu personification of the goddess of shadow. Chhaya Devi looked exactly like Samugna, and Surya could not make out that she is her shadow. He lived with Chhaya Devi and she gave birth to two sons, Savarni Manu and Shani, and two daughters, Dhabadi and Viyati. When God Shani was in the womb of Chhaya, Shiva Bhaktini Chhaya was so engrossed in the penance of Lord Shiva that she did not care for her food. She prayed so intensely during her penance that the prayers had a profound influence on her child. As a result of such great penance of Chhaya, without food or shade in the blazing sun, the complexion of Shani became black. Therefore, Shani was born dark. Right from his birth, Shani had inherited great powers through his mother's penance. At his birth, Surya, or the sun, who was eager to look at his son, was only disappointed to see the color of his child. He even suspected if Shani was his own child. At the first look of Shani, the sun went into an eclipse, and this was termed as bad luck. Receiving an unjustified and wrong treatment from his father, Shani was also unhappy with the way Surya treated his mother post his birth. He saw that his father was insulting his mother. Shani saw his father with a cruel gaze. As a result, Surya's body was also charred black. Lord Shiva advised Surya and explained to him about what had happened. Surya accepted his fault and apologized. Shani was born on Vaisakh Vaidya Chaturdashi Amavasya, which is observed as a Shani Amavasya or Shani Jayanti. Shani is said to never cause any effects on an individual until 16 years of age. This theory originates from the story of Shiva Puran. Sage Pippalada was born to Sage Dadhichi and his wife Swarcha. At the time when Dadhichi gave up his life to donate his bones to Indra to help him defeat the demon Vritra, his wife Swarcha was pregnant with Pippalada. To know the full story behind the death of Sage Dadhichi, watch the video linked above. When Swarcha came to know about the death of her husband, she placed the infant Pippalada under a peepal tree. Then she committed suicide to reunite with her husband. The infant Pippalada was taken care of by Dadhichi's sister, Dadhimati. Pippalada was upset over his father's death even before his birth. He was told by the Devas that the reason behind Dadhichi's early death was the trouble of Shani on him. He wanted to avenge Shanidev for causing trouble to his father during his lifetime. Pippalada cursed Shanidev to not be a part of universe anymore. As a result, Shanidev fell from the galaxy. However, after the Devas intervened, Pippalada agreed to forgive Shani on the condition that none below 16 would get affected by his adverse effects. Shani, to save his life, promised the same and never troubled anyone below 16 years of age. In Hinduism, Hanuman and Ganesh are the two gods who are not afflicted by Shani. In Ramayana, the boon of Lord Shiva and Brahma made Ravan invincible. He wanted a similar fate for his son Meghnad. And so when Meghnad was about to be born, Ravan kidnapped all the 9 planets and placed them in the 11th position, so his newborn too could be immortal and invincible. This made him lock up all the planets, including the Saturn, that is Shanidev, in a place where it would be difficult for them to get out. However, Hanuman reached the place when he was searching for Ma Sita in Lanka after she was kidnapped by Ravan. It was then Lord Hanuman rescued Shanidev from Ravan. As a thank you gesture, Shanidev gave a boon to Lord Hanuman that the effect of Shani's inauspiciousness will never affect him in any way. In return, Lord Hanuman mentioned that none of his devotees should be affected as well. Shanidev obliged. This is the reason why people worship Shanidev on Saturday and why Shani does not cause adversities to Hanuman's devotees. Feeding black dogs is also said to overcome the ill effects of Shani. Driven by astrological prescriptions, many people feed black dogs and are sometimes also advised to keep a black dog in the house. Shanidev is said to trouble and harass those individuals under the influence of Sadhe Sati, but this is entirely false. Shani and Yama are the lords of justice and only give fruits of one's deeds. Shanidev only punishes those who are involved in ill deeds. Like a judge, he also rewards those who perform good deeds and gives them progress in their lives. He forces people to be disciplined, to understand that one needs to be humble, focused, patient, and hardworking to achieve success.